good. We have discussed about economic liberalism. That means freedom of customs barriers or trade barriers. That means uniform system of ways and measures, uniform system of currency, etc. Now, now we were speaking about these aristocrats and all. Later, the year is far away, because in your textbook they have not given in a continuous order. So in 1834, very late after these old nation state formation, they had made a zollverein. Zollverein means a customs union. Customs union specially for restriction from or to remove or abolish the trade barriers. Abolish the trade barriers. They have made, or middle class people made, a customs union that was known as zollverein in 1834. The zollverein's main aim, I have told you, abolish the trade barriers, to make uniform currency, same currency, okay, uniform currency and uniform ways and measures. Also, they had transport system, efficient railway, for example, transport here in the sense railway. Railway also they have introduced. So, zollverein was a customs union. Its main aim was to abolish the trade barrier, make the uniform currency, abolish the trade restriction and the uniform ways and measures, and also efficient railway. This efficient railway in turn, which helped for or boosting the nation state formation. So liberalism had mainly three important steps. Middle class, it was one thing, that right to freedom and equality before law, and political liberalism means a freedom of right to vote, okay, for men and women. Then economic liberalism means they had no barriers, trade barrier, uniform measures, ways and measures, currencies, etc. These all termed as liberalism, okay. Next thing, so this uniform system of ways and measures, and we have seen that after this, the conservatism, another important term in your textbook, that is known as conservatism. What is conservatism? Conservatism means they were the people who believed in age-old thing. Believed in age-old age-old practices. They were. It is known as conservatism. Means they had believed in monarchy. They did not want any nation state, monarchy, then a church. These all they had believed. They did not support for the nation state formation. They were stick to the monarch, church, old institutions, tradition, etc. They were known as conservatives. These conservatives together, you can see these conservatives together. For example, the conservatives of Poland, Russia, Prussia, Prussia, Poland, etc. They had defeated Napoleon in the Battle of Waterloo. Waterloo battle, Napoleon was defeated. So these conservatives in the Battle of Waterloo, they had defeated Napoleon, and they were the countries like Russia, Prussia, Austria. Austria also, you can another country, Austria, they had collectively defeated Napoleon, because Napoleon's drawback they came to know. So they had collectively defeated Napoleon. And after this Napoleon's defeat, Napoleon had annexed many part of Europe, right? So after defeat, France was a very vast territory when Napoleon was ruling. And after this defeat, they understood that these territories had to be relieved, or it had to be given back. And this much territories of France together, it cannot constitute. That is why they had they had distributed these territories, and for that purpose in 1815 Duke Metternich of Austria or Austrian Chancellor, okay, he was known as Duke Metternich. He had hosted a meeting in Austria that was known as Treaty of Vienna. Okay, so Treaty of Vienna was made, means Napoleon had defeated these countries. They made a treaty that was known as Treaty of Vienna, and in order to undo the changes which brought by the Napoleon. So why they had made the Treaty of Vienna in 1815? To undo the changes which brought by Napoleon. And according to the treaty, they had made an agreement. France territory they had given back to many other countries. Northern side of France, many states were set up in order to stop the territorial expansion in future. Okay, and Netherlands was given some part of Belgium. So Treaty of Vienna you have to study very well, which means changes they had made in the territorial expansion the Napoleon had brought. So first thing, Netherlands, which got some part of Belgium, Prussia was given some part of Saxony, then Austria was given some part of Russia was given a part of Poland, then Austria was given the control of Italy, okay, and Netherlands was given the control of Belgium. So Netherlands, Belgium, Austria, Italy, then Prussia, Saxony, and Russia, some part of Poland. This arrangement they had done. So this was to change the administrative system brought by the Napoleon, or to undo. Undo means to cancel that expansion brought by the Napoleon. This was done in Treaty of Vienna. It was hosted by Duke Metternich of Austria, and the main initiative taken by Prussia, and it was made in 1815. So this is known as Treaty of Vienna. This is one of the important thing. Another thing we have to study, that is many revolutionaries have participated. So you could see after this conservatives brought back this administration, or they had got enough territories, many revolutionaries came up in France. These revolutionaries, main one of the revolutionary was known as Mazzini, Giuseppe Mazzini. He was a very revolutionary. He was a member of Carbonari. Carbonari was a secret system or secret institution, underground institution, Carbonari. He was a member. And also another important that Mazzini's another important is that his another important this was young Italy. Another important secret institution or underground institution he had made, that was known as Young Italy in Marseilles and Young Europe in Bern. These two important secret agency or secret institution or underground institution he had made in order to oppose the conservatives. So conservatives were against the nation state. They brought that after the Napoleon was defeated, they brought the conservative regime once again. Bourbon dynasty started ruling in France. They had distributed the areas according to their wish, and during this time many revolutionaries sprang up in France. So in that, one of the revolutionary, he was known as Giuseppe Mazzini. He was a member of Carbonari. He had started two other important secret underground institution named as Young Italy and Young Europe. So this is about the topic, that Treaty of Vienna and the revolutionaries.